to this right now is 37 years of nursing experience. 37 years. I'm not ashamed to say I am 60 years old. I remember what blue skies looked like. I remember as a small child looking up at the sky and watching a contrail. I was probably 3 or 4 years old sitting on a tricycle. It was March, it was really cold. It could have been a contrail. It was probably, looking back, some of their first geoengineering attempts. What I look at now in the intensive care unit where I work, I see every year something different happening. This winter, I didn't see a lot of flu. And interesting, the people that got the flu got the shot. What I see coming up on cultures now when people are testing for the flu, I see coronavirus, I see rhinovirus. That's the common cold. People are getting pneumonias from the common cold. This year, the theme seemed to be atypical pneumonia. What's atypical pneumonia? What that means in medical speak is something they cannot explain. Alveolar hemorrhage. The tiny little pockets in your lungs where you exchange oxygen. Several patients I noticed this year had alveolar hemorrhage. What's that about? This is something that we all have to talk to our doctors about, and they're not going to listen, I can tell you, because I talk to the doctors. We have very good intensivists in our intensive care unit, and they are not listening to me. We have to speak up. We have to speak loud.
International corporations are modifying our weather all the time, and they're modifying it in ways that cover thousands and thousands of square miles. Programs are impacting microclimates needed for our crops to survive and needed for pollination. The other issue is that a lot of times we're talking about mitigation for climate change. It's rather an undefined term at this period of time. And so what happens is that many times we're talking about artificially putting chemicals like sulfur or particulates into the atmosphere in what they call geoengineering schemes to reduce, supposedly, global warming. And if you take and you put up into our skies chemicals to reduce the amount of sunlight reaching the earth, you are going to begin to reduce crop production. Without the process of photosynthesis, whereby plants from direct sunlight gain the energy to grow, to produce crops, we are going to find ourselves, if we mitigate in that direction, impacting the crop production not only here in the United States, but worldwide. What you're seeing now, a lot of times many scientists know, especially at NASA and in other areas, that the skies that we're seeing are not normal cloud formations. These are man-made. In California, the State Department of Health drinking water tests were examined between 1970 and this year, and we found unusual spiking in barium, aluminum, strontium, manganese, and all of these spiked at the same time in various drinking water supplies across the state of California and also in Arizona. So what's happening with these atmospheric tests is that aluminum, as one example, gets into the root systems of our trees, and it looks like the trees are dying of drought, but they're not. Many of our forests in Redding, California, and other areas are dying from warmer temperatures produced by persistent jet contrails, also impacting tree health and crop health. They know from scientific studies back in the 1970s that they deplete beneficial ozone in the atmosphere by releasing nitric acid.
Ooh.